Sending messages in SAP ERP made easy. It is possible to send messages to another SAP user directly in SAP ERP and SAP S/4HANA. And this already in the standard and without any add-on or installation. In this video, you will learn about the different possibilities about sending messages in SAP ERP and SAP S/4HANA. Enjoy this video and let's get started. So if you like to, you can send a short message within the SAP system. Here I am logged into the same SAP system with two different SAP users. So on the left-hand side with Andreas G and in the right-hand side with Andreas G2. And you can send a short message with or access sending short messages on three typical ways. So the first is in the menu bar under system and then short message. There you will open up this. The second option is to directly open up the transaction S00. And the third option is then if you're going back into the SAP Easy Access menu, and here you can open up the SAP Business Workplace, so SBWP, or you could also hit this button, SAP Business Workplace, or hit the key combination control and F12. And over here, you have also the button New Message to open up this window for sending short messages. Under title, for example, here we're just typing test. This is a test. We would like to send this message to Andreas G2 and the recipient. So we type in his or her SAP user ID. In this case, it's Andreas G2. And here you have different options to select. Now we just directly want to send it as an express message. If you want to, you can send it as copy. So on CC or on blind copy, so BCC, what you like to. So in this case, this is totally fine. And now we click on this send button, or you could also hit the key combination shift and F8. And then now we don't see anything because the message will appear if the recipient, in this case Andreas G2, makes any action. So in this case, I'm just clicking on this back button, or you could also hit the 3 key, and now we see that the express document test received from author Andreas Geiger. If we double click, then we can see detailed information about this message, so the title and the body, the message itself. If we want to, we can make any actions on this. So again, we can send it, we can do a resubmit, we can do a move, a create link, we can delete this message, or we can reply what we prefer and like. So the second option is to send a single message with a function module. To use this, we can open up the transaction code SE37. And here we are in the function builder, and in here we type in the function module th underscore pop up, and then we hit the F8 key on our keyboard or click on this button, and then we are able to type in some input parameters. And it is important that you type in your client, your user, and your message. You can leave the other input parameters blank. We don't need to type in. So here we are in the client 400. We would like to send it to Andreas G2. And in here we would like to send a message. So this is a test. Please subscribe what we like. So we can execute this function module with this execute button, or again with the F8 key on your keyboard. And then the right user, in this case Andreas G2, because I'm on the same Windows computer, I am receiving this on the Windows, and here I am seeing the message. So this is a test, please subscribe. And we can see what from whom the message was sent. So in this case, Andreas G. So this is really useful because the recipient, in this case Andreas, did you, will directly receive this message without changing, without executing another action. This is really helpful if you, for example, would like to ask him or her if she or he wants to go to lunch. what do you prefer? And in here, I have created an own ABAP program to simply use this function module th_popup, because sometimes, or I'm quite confident that not every user has the authorization for the function builder, so for the transaction code SE37. And in this case, if you can create an own ABAP report, create a transaction code in SE93 to make it more convenient. And in this case, here you can type in a user to whom you want to send the message, and you can enter the message. And for example, if we execute this report, and here once again to Andreas G2, and the message, please subscribe ERPM. And now we're sending this message, and once again the right user Andreas G2 directly receives this message. This is also really useful in your daily work. The third option is to create a system message. And to create a system message, you can open up the transaction code SM02. And in here, we don't see any system message right now, but here you can create one. So you can click on this create button or use the key combination Control and F10. And in here, you can type in a message that you would like to. So for example, please subscribe ERP up if you want to. And in here you can set up the range in what the message should occur. So display to, display on. And so this is fine because today is 7th of April. I would like to display this today at 11 p.m. and I would like to delete it after 1 month. If you want to specify the message on one specific server, on one specific client, you can set it up. In my case, I leave it blank and I click on the save and enter, and now I have added a system message. And for example, if I log in once again with one user, so this is the right user in this case. Now we're seeing here the system message. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any question regarding sending messages in SAP ERP and SAP S/4HANA, leave it in the comment section. Please like this video if you liked it. And please subscribe this YouTube channel to never miss great upcoming videos in the future. Thank you very much, and then see you in the next video.